Hello. Welcome to part four of making our ball bounce. And what we had finished in the last part of our movie is we basically were left with something that looked like this. And the first thing I want to adjust in this is the timing, because we want to show there's a bit of gravity as it falls. It's going to accelerate. And as it hits the ground and moves up, it's going to go from fast to slow. So I'm going to just click on my first keyframe, and I'm going to find something that we call our velocity editor or our set ease for multiple parameters. I'm going to open that up. Inside here gives us the keyframe. You can see the animation is on the right side of the keyframe. And if I was on this keyframe, the information is happening on the left side. So clearly, my keyframe is on frame one, and the animation is happening to the right time value. So I'm going to make this fall quite the value quite high. Maybe I'll make it 80 and apply. And you can see that now it's going to go slow to fast. Anything that's on the horizontal is slow. Anything that's on the vertical is fast. And we can see that we have quite a bit of, we almost have until frame 11 of a little bit of horizontal, and then it just completely drops off. And what that's going to look like when I play it back is going to go slow to fast, and then there's going to be nothing at the end. Now I'm going to go to the last keyframe, and I'm going to basically do the same. I'm going to go do the same. I'm going to move over here, and I'm going to press 80, apply. And now our animation is going to look slightly different. It's going to go slow, it's going to speed up, it's going to be going fast, and moving to slow. And if I just press stop here and loop, you'll get an idea of the way that the timing will look different. Okay. You can see now it eases up and it eases out. Now the first thing I can do, is I can take all of this animation and put it on twos. So I'm going to select this group of frames. I'm going to press this button, Create Keyframes On. All the frames are going to be on frame 2, from frame 1 to frame 31. And now we have everything simply on twos. But one of the things I want to change is I want to make this last drawing flat, just to give a little bit of, I'm just zooming in by pressing the number 2. I'm going to just make that one squash a little bit. And what I'm going to do with this other frame, I'm going to just mildly take that, and I'm going to favor it to the bottom. I'm trying to keep the volumes pretty simple. I'm going to make it speed up. But the one thing I also might want to do is remove some of these tweens. Maybe these ones. Re-in between it, so as the ball is falling, we can see it's starting to change its shape. And then I'll just put those keyframes back. So now the change we have is looks a little bit more like that. And I'll do the same thing on the way up. Maybe this one I'll give a little bit of stretch to. Maybe I'll do this one manually. I'll just maybe a little bit less gouache. Let's take a look at what our final result looks like. Well, this is a very rubbery ball. It's changing shape quite a bit in this action. Maybe I've made it a little bit too much, but you're getting the idea of how to use some of the tools in Harmony to do a simple bouncing ball. Thank you for your time, and hope you enjoyed the videos.